Hello, my name is Jan Pinkas and I work as a technical support for Sinclair heat pumps. In this video, I will show you the basic settings of our Estherm Ontario heat pumps. The entire Estherm Ontario series has the same user interface and the same software. Therefore, the controller is same for monoblock, hydrobox and all-in-one unit. Here, we will use a controller from the monoblock. After connecting the unit to electricity, main user screen appears. In the upper part, you'll find the basic information such as date, time, mode, outdoor temperature, and output water temperature from the heat pump. In the middle of the screen, you will find a temperature control, and at the bottom, you can find the basic control buttons. Buttons for entering the menu, mode changing, turning on the domestic hot water, and the button for turning on the heat pump. Press the home button to get to the main menu. It's divided into 5 sections. The default language is English. Other languages are set as follows. Press the home button, general, go to the second page, choose language, and confirm with the save icon. Date and time can be set on the line above. In the next step, press commission. There is a service bar. To enter, insert 4x0 and 4x8. If the heat pump is going to prepare also domestic hot water, it needs to be enabled. Press the function, go to tank, select yes and confirm. When the heat pump is used also for heating the domestic hot water, it's recommended to have an electric heating element in the tank for disinfection and possible emergency mode. Whether the heating element is present in the domestic hot water tank or not, it needs to be set. On the fourth page, click on tank heater and select logic number 2. If you don't have domestic hot water tank, NA appears. Estherm Ontario heat pumps in split version already have a backup electric heater, which is already built inside the indoor unit. Monoblocks have a possibility of controlling an external heater. Here, you also need to adjust the settings. The electric heater is disabled in factory settings. If you want to activate it, which is recommended, go to the second page, click on optional e-heater, and set following settings. More detailed explanation of a backup electric heater can be found in a separate video. In this section, everything is set. Go back to the main menu. The heat pump mode is set as follows. Go to function and press mode. If the unit is only going to be used for heating, select heating. If it is also going to prepare domestic hot water, select heating plus domestic hot water. For summer season, choose only domestic hot water. All that remains is to set desired temperatures. Return to the main menu and select parameters. On the second line, WOT, heat. Here, select the desired temperature at the outlet of the heat pump. This is the temperature that will enter the heating system. On the fifth line, T water tank. Here, select the desired temperature in the domestic hot water tank. On the next page, hysteresis can be set. On the third line, the drop from the target temperature is set, after which heat pump starts heating again. Value of 5 to 6 degrees is suitable for radiators. For underfloor heating, it's 2 to 3 degrees Celsius. On the next line, the domestic hot water hysteresis is set. Here, we recommend to leave the default settings of 5 degrees Celsius. Return to the main menu and start the unit with the icon in the lower right corner. That's all from the basic settings tutorial. If your installation is more complex and more detailed settings are needed, please contact your installation company. On behalf of the Sinclair team, I wish you a nice rest of the day.